Sống sống. Okay, very very good morning to everyone. We will discuss the next topic. We call it, generally call them as engineering economy. Now you understand what is mean by economy. Economy is related to monetary issues. Monetary issues means financial or amount issues, okay. Now generally in a construction industry, let us take an example of RMC plant, ready mix plant, okay. In that, what exactly you are going to do, okay? You are getting the resources from other place, you are putting it in a batching plant and getting the concrete, and you are distributing it to some customer, okay. You are going to distribute that concrete into some customer. Where does this economic part is there for in RMC plant? Economy is, when you understand in a broader way, it is the social science, means it is related to society, societal part, okay. That studies production, distribution and consumption of goods and services for the human welfare. This is related to social science part. Still not yet we have into the construction field where you can define engineering economy or economy in a different way. But when you consider in a general way, you can understand that it is nothing but studying the various things, various aspects, issues, properties, uses, advantage, how it is done, in what way we can do it in a better way, related to production of something. The production of something may be goods, may be agricultural, may be civil, may be mechanical, okay, something, the elements and their distribution. Both goods and services, we consider the study for goods as well as services, okay. Goods means a physical component, service means a useful from other person to have a that particular work done, okay, to have a particular work done. So generally we call them as a goods and service. Services, for example, you go for a workshop or a bike repair service center, what you are going to do? You get service of your bike, means you are, some other person is doing your work, okay, your work, and he is getting some amount for that. So goods and service, their production, their distribution and their consumption. So studying all these things, we call them as a economics. Now as I said before, economy in a particular way, it relates to the funds, monetary aspects, money issues, okay. So wherever production, wherever distribution comes, wherever consumption comes, always there will be a transaction of money. So in wholesome, you can say that it is a study of both production, distribution, consumption as well as monetary transaction, So we come across in construction industry, okay. So in that, what will be the economic definition? We can say that it's a branch of general economics, okay. Which consists the application of techniques, expertise of economics, means there will be techniques, maybe MS programming software, maybe Excel software, maybe some other software, maybe some other scheduling technique, maybe some other planning techniques, okay, some computer programs, okay. And expertise of economic, means some senior person who has the knowledge of this money, who has the knowledge of this monetary issues, who has the knowledge of all this goods, service, supply, distribution, okay, consumption. So the person who is having all the knowledge and all the techniques and application to that some particular area. So I have given example. So the particular area may be RMC plant. Let us say we can say the RMC plant. So what we are going to do, which type of technique you are going to do? So we can go for O&M, sorry, what is that? Operations management technique, okay. From which resources, we have multiple resources for supply of cement, multiple resources of supply of aggregate, okay. Similarly for all other things. So which is distance wise very nearer, which is cost wise, which is wherever nearer, okay. So which is good quality material supplying, so all those things, aspects will be considered. And whichever is giving least cost or efficiency, so we are going to select that one. So why, who is going to help that one? The expertise person is going to help in the selection of best alternative, help in the selection of best alternative, such that the total process achieves economy. So the total process achieves economy. So now economy means of reducing the cost, reducing the cost in a very, very efficient way. So that is the definition for economics. I hope it is clear. Now, what are the economic goals? Using this economy as a tool, what type of objective we can achieve? What type of goals we can achieve? Okay. A high level of employment means what? A lot of people can get jobs. Okay. First one goal. Second is what? Price stability. A proper selection of decision. Proper selection of decision will make the price of goods and services in a stable way. So sudden jump, sudden fall in the prices will not take place if you have a correct economic decision. Okay. Efficiency means what? Using less and less resources, you get more and more output. That is the efficiency part. An equitable distribution of income means what? All the persons, maybe supplier, maybe customer, okay? So everyone will be having an income in a distributed way. Some persons will suddenly will not become rich. Some persons will not get money, something like that, okay? It is not going to happen. So one of the goals of economy is that every person will be having equal distribution of income. Equal distribution of income, one of the goals. Growth, every person, every industry, every sector will grow, okay, will grow. Engineering economics, okay, now what is this? It deals with the methods that enable to take the decision towards minimizing the cost, maximizing the benefit to a business organization. Obviously, if you have a business, your aim or your objective is always having the cost minimum, benefit maximum. Benefit means what? Profit maximum. Okay. So it deals with the process. It deals with the decision taking process such that cost is reduced, profit is maximized. Okay. So that is the engineering economics. Principles. What are those principles? First and foremost, we can say that developing the alternative. So I have given the example of ready mix plant, where what you are exactly going to do. So your batching plant is situated in somewhere near outskirts of the Belgaum. Then lot of people nearby villages or nearby crushers will have the opportunity to supply you the aggregates or supply you the cement. So you will be having a lot of alternative. One of the principle of economy is that you should develop alternatives. Means what? You should not depend upon single source, single alternative. So that is what? Final choice is among the alternative. So you always go for multiple resources. You create more than one resource such that you achieve economy. How? How you achieve economy? The person who is supplying a high quality product in a reasonable cost, so you can get the economy. Okay. First principle is developing the alternative. Second is what? Focus on the difference. Whenever you are selecting an alternative, you should always concentrate on the difference. You should always concentrate on the difference. Example for difference is maybe the cost of supply, maybe the transportation, maybe the distance, maybe the quality of product, maybe the loyalty of supplier. That is also one of the difference. Okay. Use a consistent viewpoint. What is that? Use a consistent viewpoint. Prospective outcome of alternatives should be constantly developed from viewpoint. Means what? You should aim at the last part. Means what? Result. By seeing the result, by visualizing the result, or by predicting the result of different outcome, you should select the alternative. Means what? Viewpoint of achieving a better concrete. Viewpoint of achieving a better concrete. Which aggregate supplier is good? which aggregate supplier is good. So that is the use of consistent viewpoint. Viewpoint from the cost, viewpoint from the quality, viewpoint from the supply time. Okay, all those aspects should be considered. Use a common unit of measure means what? For one supplier you should not take a distance, for another supplier you should not take the time of supply. Okay, so a constant unit of measure, maybe time supply, maybe supply of time, maybe the distance, maybe the credibility, okay, maybe the loyalty. So one parameter you should use to check the alternative, to check the different alternatives. What it will do? Common unit of measure, it will eases, it will make your process easy in the analysis and comparison. Okay, consider all relevant criteria means what? Selection of preferred alternative requires use of criteria. Criteria means what? Again, the same example I can give. Criteria means on what basis, you are going to select a particular alternative. On what basis you are going to select the particular alternative. So while selecting, you go for different criteria. Okay, for faster construction you require the early possible supply time. Okay, for faster construction or faster production of concrete you require early supply of the goods. Okay, so that will be the relevant criteria in your this type of RMC production. For different high grade concrete production, for that what will be the relevant criteria? Your aggregates should be cubical in nature. The person who is supplying the aggregates, who has a cubical shape of aggregates, then that will be your relevant criteria. Okay, like that. Make uncertainty explicit means how you can understand this statement. Uncertainty is inherent. Uncertainty is inherent in estimating future outcomes of alternative. Means what? Whatever alternative you select, there will be always uncertainty. So keeping that uncertainty, you are always predicting some uncertainty results. Okay, that should always be considered. That is the meaning of uncertainty explicit. Means how on paper he will tell within 3 days of giving order I will supply the material, but there is always some uncertainty, maybe some labor strike, maybe some vehicle breakdown, maybe some road work. So always there will be a extra time required. So you should always keep the uncertainty as a explicit term. Explicit means what? You cannot exclude that one. It is always inbound in nature. Okay, revisit your decision means what? After all you are have done the analysis, still you go for revisit, rethink. Okay, check what have left. Okay, like that you are going to revisit your decisions. Now the what is this microeconomics? Okay, so in a broader way we can say that micro and macro. In attention I can tell that micro means studying a smaller units, maybe individual person, maybe individual houses, maybe small companies, maybe small industry or a particular sector of industry. Okay, individual means a person can be studied for his decision. A small company which is producing mechanical component or a cement construction industry. Okay, like that a particular set of industry, particular persons, if we are studying, then we call them as a microeconomics. Okay, so it deals with individual units such as individual firms, individual unit prices means prices related to some commodity, or unit income. Unit income means for particular group of income, maybe middle income group, maybe labor category, maybe all company employees. So studying some particular things we call them as a microeconomics. Okay, in this you understand this. Study is made as a part to whole, not whole to part. Part to whole means small parts are studied. Later they will get accumulated and create a bigger picture. Okay, so you have studied some survey and all. So in that you understand that statement part to whole, not a part whole to part. So part to whole means Total work is divided into small segments, and small segments is studied. Later on, all are combined. So it is the principle. Example, a market study of a particular sector. Okay, segments of economy. It generally deals with what? Supply and demand of individual markets. Supply and demand of some individual market. Market may be some consumer goods, fast moving goods, okay, some construction mechanical components, okay. Individual customer behavior. In this microeconomics, a particular set of customers will be selected and those behaviors are only studied, okay. Individual labor market, such as demand for labor, maybe labors required for road work, maybe required for construction of houses, okay, apartments, okay, like that. Only the particular set of labors are studied. Okay, now when we come to macro, macro is nothing but a bigger type of study. Okay, it relates to the total country, it relates to the total world, okay, like that. Macroeconomics, a government study related to the financial term is generally we call them as a macroeconomics. Okay, related to nation, related to world, related to some bigger aspects, we call them as a macroeconomics. Study of whole economy means what? All agriculture, all services, all goods, each and every concept, if we study, then it's called as a macroeconomics. It studies aggregate variables. Don't get confused. Aggregate in this context means all variables, all demand, all supply, all national output and inflation. So studying these bigger terms, we call them as macroeconomics. Okay, so aggregate variables, all demand, okay, for related to a particular country, we call them as a macroeconomics. So what it deals with monetary, a nation's financial issues, like budget, like procurement of some big foreign investment, okay. So it deals with those kind of things. Reasons for inflation means what? Year by year the value of money is getting increased. Today 100 rupees product, after 3 months it will become 150. So that increase in the money for the same product, we call them as a increase in price, we call them as a inflation. Okay, so unemployment, studying of this unemployment, their reasons nation wise, is called a part of the macroeconomics. Economic growth of a country, so the total country's economic growth, their GDP, their GNP, okay, so all those things will be studied under macroeconomics. International trade and globalization, this will be the part of a nation's foreign policy. Okay, nation's foreign policy, there how we are going to do the trade with other countries, what will be the taxes for import export. Globalization means what? Getting the foreign technology or foreign industry, or opening up of the local market for the other country industry. Reasons for difference in the living standard, why some people will always have expenditure more than lakh per month, or more than 10,000, or less than 5,000. Why the country people living standards are different, okay? So this is the difference, you can say. In micro, the study of economy as an individual or a group level or a company level is studied, okay? Individual level, group level or a company level. But when you come to the macro economics, a national economy as a whole is studied. Industrial issues are studied in microeconomics. Particular industry, a aeroplane manufacturing industry, a shipyard, okay, like that. Issues that affect the economy as a whole, the strikes we can study, okay, labor strike, or maybe some pandemic breakdown, okay, something like that if we study. And what are the effects on the total national income or economical part, it is considered as the macroeconomics. Okay.